Afternoon, welcome viewers. Welcome to Talking Politics. Talking Politics is a program on ITV Abuja where we get to analyze some burning issues in the political setting of the country. Today I will be anchoring the program. I am Charity Tanko, and on the program today we shall be looking at direct primaries. Many Nigerians are not familiar with the word direct election, though it was used in 1993, and that particular election was the one that produced the acclaimed winner of the 1993 general election, who happens to be the late MKO Abiola. And going forward, AC used direct elections in the direct primaries in the 2011 election. Since then, nobody has heard anything about direct elections until now, with the coming of Adams Oshiomhole, who is the national chairman of the All Progressives Congress. He has introduced direct primaries. And now what we have is APC has adopted direct primaries for presidential election, and indirect, the states can choose whether to go by direct or indirect primary. Now we'll have to look at the gains and the losses of this direct primaries. To discuss that issue, I have with me in the studio Jide Ojo, developmental consultant and also a newspaper columnist. You're welcome.
Thanks for having me. Good afternoon.
Bella. Yeah, I also have comrade Sam Ede. He's a political analyst. You're welcome.
Thank you.
Well, quickly, I will start with you, Jide Ojo. What is your take on direct primaries?
Thank you, Charity. Direct primary is a very desirable way to include members of a political party in the choice of the party's flag bearer. And our jurisprudence, or let me say our law, actually gave an option of indirect and direct primaries to political parties. When you look at section 87, subsection 2 of the Electoral Act 2010 as amended, it says in that subsection 2 of section 87 that parties are to use either direct or indirect primary. And in direct primaries, all members of parties are encouraged to, you know, to participate and to be given a level playing field. And then if you are adopting indirect primaries, it went step by step on what and what is expected of you, from presidential to governorship to Senate, House of Reps. The Electoral Act in Section 87 articulated all of this. So it is not so much, when political parties say, oh, we have adopted or we have a direct primary in our law, you know, it's a derivation from the Electoral Act. Because you will recall that APC just came into being in 2013, February 2013. But the Electoral Act predates APC's birth. So it's there. But the major gains of direct primary is that it's an inclusive process. It enables all members of the party, genuine members of the party, bona fide members of the party, to participate in the choice of the flag bearers. Unlike the current situation where we have indirect primary that is prone to corruption. You recall that if I want to fast track and talk about recent developments that actually even encourage APC to say they want to adopt direct primary, it was arising from the July the primaries conducted in June 2018 in Ekiti. When that election was first conducted using the indirect primary, which is the delegate system, which is what many people are familiar with, that election was inconclusive because there was disruption. Some members of the party, I don't want to call them hoodlums, disrupted the process because they said the outcome is being skewed in favor of a particular aspirant. Now, at the end of the day, the party had to reconvene another day to conclude that, to do that primary afresh. And some of the candidates, over 30 of them, who were aspirants under APC in Ekiti State, some of them, and I will mention too, Senator Babafemi Ojudu and the former governor, Engineer Shegwoni, said, look, the way out for an inclusive primary is to go direct. Because In that Ekiti election, there were allegations that one of the aspirants actually count the delegates in three different towns. You understand? And buzzed them in and was pledged to give them 1 million. After, and that maybe some 100,000 had been given after the election. And you know, according to the aggrieved aspirant, they said they agreed before the primaries that if you are an illiterate delegate, you can approach the agent of any of the aspirant. But they now discovered that even those who are literate were going to a particular party agent, and he was recording their VIN number, their party number and all of that. What is that for? To settle after the primaries must have been held. So they were the ones that said, look, going forward, the party should look at the possibility of organizing the direct primary. So in the forthcoming Osun election, September 22, the primaries were held in Oshogbo on July 21st, Saturday, July 21st. And the party said, look, this time around we want to go direct. And forthwith we want to go direct because we don't want what happened in Ekiti to repeat itself. Of course, they had direct primary in Osun. It was not a foolproof system because some of the aggrieved party members also have defected because there is only one ticket for governorship. And there are several of them, over 12 of them. So those who did not win also alleged that the outcome was orchestrated in favor of a particular aspirant.
All right, you hold your thoughts there while I go over to Sam. Mm-hmm. Would you say direct primaries will enhance, promote democracy in this country?
Well, I think the indirect system of choosing a candidate in a political party is far, far better than the direct system.
Okay, why do you think it's far better?
Why I think so is that in the political parties, you find out that in every ward you have delegates, you have executives who turned out to be delegates of those political parties. Those ward delegates were elected by members of the party to protect their interest and at the same time take decisions on behalf of them within the party. If you call for direct primaries, it might be hijacked by outsiders within the political space who are not members of the party.
Yes, talking about hijack, I've had people say that. How possible it is?
Let me explain. The direct primary system, today I can confidently tell you that most political parties and their executives are not being paid for anything. They are just members of the political parties. They are there to serve the party. And in doing this, if you bring direct system, they will have nothing to do in the party. They would not have responsibilities to handle in the party. Today, as a representative of the party within your ward, you're mandated to make sure the party wins election and make sure a credible candidate is being selected, who have contributed so much to the party, is being selected to represent the party's interest at the national level within government. But if you bring direct system, anybody can hire anybody and say they are members, disrupt the process. People will come in and I'm telling you.
You must be a card carrying member.
I will tell you, most of the people calling, I can tell you, there are parties today you go, they don't have register of members. You cannot ascertain who are members of the political party. I can confidently tell you that. There are parties you go to, you cannot ascertain that, this person is a member. But once election comes in, people who are looking for direct primaries, I think in doing that, if I'm a candidate and I'm running for election and you're bringing everybody within the party to run for the election, lobbying party faithfuls to get the ticket, I will be spending more.
On direct primaries?
On direct primaries. Because the people I have to meet are in thousands.
All right, I only thought that. Chidojo, do you agree that you spend more on direct primaries, looking at the fact that there have been allegations that delegates actually the delegate process is what costs a lot of money.
Thank you. I understand the fear that is expressed by my colleague on this panel. The concerns being expressed is born out of the fact that there is no valid membership register in almost all our political parties.
Okay.
They don't have party membership. So many of them have been mouthing, oh, we have 18 million members, we have 20 million. Where is the register? Show us. Mm-hmm. So when they don't have party membership register, how then do you know who should vote and who should not vote? That's where they shot themselves in the foot. Mm-hmm. Ordinarily, the same APC is doing registration as we speak.
Registration of
party members. They said they call it a registration and revalidation of membership. They started that all about 2 weeks ago. And news reports say that in many states it has not taken off. And it may likely not take off because of the deliberate interest
of
some people. Now, two is what he also alluded to. The so-called delegates who have been chaperoned into office under a very doubtful, integrity deficient congresses and convention. Recall that in May, in many states, there was allegations of consensus, and that divided the party in such a way that in many states there are parallel congresses. And when you have parallel congresses, the governor's camp is one, the senator's camp is another.
The House of Representatives.
So in some, they have more than two. Now, I'm afraid for APC, and you ask me why. The APC is shooting itself in the foot by saying that in many states now, they are saying we are even going consensus. We are not even doing direct or indirect. I've heard it in Kebbi, they said they want to do consensus. In Ogun, yesterday, they said they want to do consensus. The Electoral Act is not in support of consensus. That section 87 I talked to you about said primary is either direct or indirect. Because what they call consensus is actually the governor's list.
Okay, but the consensus candidacy, I think it comes under the party's constitution.
That is party constitution. Can the party constitution supersede the Electoral Act?
Okay, now, Comrade Sam, what do you have to say on that?
What I want to say is that what I want to base my thought on is the indirect.
Okay.
The indirect system is the best system, the college system we have borrowed from the United States. Is the best system for our democracy for now.
But you and I know that over the years, there have been allegations of heavy influence on delegates when it comes to...
That I don't want to believe, because President Muhammadu Buhari ran in the platform of APC where you had an indirect primaries. Without funds, he merged the president.
Okay.
If that, let's use that as a case study.
Right.
You now find out that it is not money that determines who picks the ticket.
Okay.
It's your relationship and your contribution to the party that makes you a candidate of that political party. It is not money. If anybody is telling you, know, the delegate system is money, tell the person is a lie.
Okay, are you now telling Nigerians that delegates don't actually get anything for voting, is that what you want Nigerians to believe?
Yes, I just want to tell. I just want to tell you.
Travel to other states just for free.
No. If you have contributed your quota to the development of that party, definitely delegates will vote for you.
Okay.
Nothing will stop that.
Okay.
But a situation whereby you just run from one party A to party B,
mm-hmm.
and then think you want to get the party's ticket,
mm-hmm.
definitely maybe you'll be putting your hand, dipping your hands into your pocket to see if you buy people's coins.
And it could possibly work.
It doesn't work. Because the man you have been working with, the devil you know is better than the angel you don't know.
That's how it works. Comrade Sam,
let's not go into, because we could remember certain things that happened in 2014. So people.
Thank you, Charity. In Lagos, I will tell you for free, and he knows, he just doesn't want to admit. The president may not have personally paid delegates. Mm. People paid for him. It was a talk of war. It's in the news. Google it. It was a naira rain for delegates in Lagos. He was an aspirant. Yeah. There were five of them. Those who were there will tell you that delegates were paid in dollars. Not even in naira, in dollars. I'm not saying the president paid.
Okay.
It's like what happened yesterday. You saw what happened.
Yeah.
The party said 45 million. Even if they put it at 100 million, the president will get people who will say, we are buying this for you. I don't know whether you get me. When former FCT minister, El-Rufai, when he alleged that some members of National Assembly were asking him to pay money to get cleared by the National Assembly, he did not pay. But who tells you that somebody possibly did not pay for him? They will not tell you that somebody paid for me. That is no. See, let me tell you what happened in Ondo, last Ondo governorship election. The same delegate system that is lording. What happened? There were two delegate lists. One from the Ondo APC, one from National Head Office. They ended up with the one by the National Office. And when you look at that outcome and the fallout of it, I don't know whether this man, Shegun, what is his surname, has withdrawn his case against Akeredolu, because they said the delegate list was doctored and that so many people were just brought in, and that's where the see and buy culture came in 2016 or thereabout, when they had the Ondo governorship primary. It's available online. That's why they just doctored the delegate list to reflect what the national wants, as against what, and that's what led to the even removal of the chairman of Ondo APC there. Now, what am I saying in essence? The delegate list is prone to corruption because there are approximately 1,500 people. You can easily buy them off if you have deep pocket. But if there are 20,000
people
who are going to be accredited to vote,
mm-hmm.
you find it difficult to now pay them such. You may not even know everybody. But this one, you know the delegate already way back in May. So you know who to reach out to. And you know, I said something in my column in May, when that Congress was going to hold. There was something that the PDP, APC headquarters did. They said they were trying to raise money for that Congress and convention. They needed 6 billion. They now asked each of the 24 state governors to pay 250,000 or thereabout. I mean, 250 million, you know, each. And when we raised eyebrow, what did the then publicity secretary of the party, Bolaji Abdullahi, what did he say? He said, look, this 250 million was money that was hold the party by the governors who have not been up to date in the payment of their membership dues.
How can
membership dues amount to such
a thing? He's calling for direct primaries.
Let me hold your thoughts.
No, did that happen or did
it? No, I don't know if it happened.
Sam, I want to ask you, in all honesty, we are talking to Nigerians now on a serious note, in all honesty. Would you say that the indirect primaries has been of immense help to the nation's democracy and electoral process?
Yes, the indirect primaries have made our democracy go. If you know what it takes to conduct a direct primary, it's just like conducting an election, a general election.
But it was done before.
Today, he just told you that the party was looking for funds to run, once INEC today is complaining that it needs
How many billion to conduct 2019 general election?
180.
If you are doing that in a political party that has followership in millions, eh? I don't know where you get the budget to conduct such primaries in every ward. But the delegate system have provided a system whereby the members of the party will elect party executives in their wards. The wards progress to the local government to the state, state to the national. You would know where to, who to hold hand in case anything goes wrong. Mm. There will be somebody you would...
What could possibly go wrong?
No, that is in case, if anything goes wrong.
Okay.
But the direct system, I can come out in any political party, buy form, I can import people if I know...
Import?
Yeah, you can import people from Lokoja to come to Abuja to stand, since it's your interest. If you carry two trailers of people, you are getting 1,000 persons in two trailers. Each trailer carries 500 persons. You know the result of such outcome. They will enter line. The in-house, they call it Kato Bayan Kato.
Mm-hmm.
Eh? I stand behind my candidate. You know what will happen. If I know that you have more people than I do, I will disrupt the process. And at the end of the day, what will happen? The election might be invalid or anything will happen in that process.
All right, we are seriously battling with time. Let me put it, Jijojo, what would you say, what would you say about insecurity? Because he just raised a valid point there.
Thank
where you.
You
have a large number of people.
See, that was the reason in advance for all the Northeast states that, oh, we can't afford to have direct primaries because of state of insecurity. But you see, there for whatever you don't want to do, you have a genuine excuse for not wanting to do it. The point is, how do you ensure inclusivity of members? Mm. I was getting to somewhere before my time ran out earlier.
Mm.
You see, when you allow governors to donate so much to fund the party during the congresses and conventions, you have more or less handed the
party to them.
To them. Now, they are the one orchestrating these direct primaries by all means. The party, in its wisdom, recall that there were issues about two different press statements on this issue. When Governor Simon Lalong addressed the press last week Thursday, he said the party said there was a direct primary for president and every other position indirect. The following day, Nabena came on here and said, no, we all direct primaries for every position, unless states that genuinely want to have reason.
The bottom line, what will be done about security?
The point is, they have charged so much. They have charged so much for nomination fee. And part of that fee should have been used to print voters' ballot paper, not to do option A4. Option A4 is not an option in this current experience. You can't queue behind people, aspirants now. What you need is to guarantee secrecy of ballot, and you need to print ballot paper. I know the logistics of conducting the direct primary is huge and it's more expensive for the party. But it will enrich very few people who have emerged as delegates, whether rightly or wrongly. But the bottom line is that it's going to generate a lot of bad blood between the governor, who is orchestrating that it must be direct primary, it must be indirect primary at all. Because the people they have already planted in the party structure, they want to put them to good use in the margins of their candidates.
The issue of insecurity, the governors are the chief security officer of their state.
All right.
They understand what security is all about.
We'll talk about that some other time. I have to hold your thoughts right there. Well, it's been Talking Politics on ITV. I've been in the studio with a very vibrant and intelligent gentleman with me here talking about the gains and losses of direct primaries. You've all heard it. Unfortunately, we cannot continue. Thank you, our gentlemen, for being part of the program. Well, stay glued to ITV for more of programs coming your way. Till we come your way again next week, same time on Talking Politics. Enjoy the rest of your day.